Your book.
Right. I beg your pardon.
Thank you. It's my first time on a commuter train. It's eclectic. What about you?
Every day, last 10 years.
10 years? You must know everyone on this train.
The regular commuters, I guess. Faces, mostly. I'm sorry, have we met?
No, I'm Joanna.
Michael.
Michael. How long is it between stops? 4 minutes?
Yeah, give or take.
4 minutes? On and off, on and off. It's so miscellaneous. I'm bothering you, aren't I?
No.
I am. I just want to read your book.
It's... I'm married.
Oh, me too.
Sorry.
I study human behavior. It's an occupational hazard.
Being married?
No, bothering people.
Oh.
I'm a conversationalist.
So, in your job, you sit down, strike up a conversation, then what?
Okay, let's say there are 100 people in this car. There are 16 personality types, as defined by psychology. Right, so I can assume that there are about 6 people of each type, with varying degrees of response to any particular situation. My job is to answer one basic question.
What's that?
What kind of person are you?
Me? Should probably ask my wife.
Let's do an experiment.
Experiment?
It's painless. It's just a simple hypothetical question.
Okay.
What if I asked you to do one little thing? It's something that you are uniquely qualified to do. It's something that's meaningless to you, but it could profoundly affect an individual on this train. Would you do it?
I'd want to know what kind of thing.
Does it matter?
Well, I think it does.
And you would never know the consequences of what you did.
Then why would I do it?
Because there would be a reward.
Uh-huh. So, what's the reward?
In the bathroom, carriage 2. Maybe there is a package. It's hidden. And inside that package is $25,000. That money is yours, plus another 75 cash. If you do this one little thing.
I don't understand.
Someone on this train does not belong. All you have to do is find them. That's it. This person is carrying a bag. You don't know what it looks like, but inside that bag is something they have stolen. This person goes by the name of Prin. It's not a real name. They will be on this train until Cold Spring. You find them, you find the bag, that $100,000 is yours. Don't leave the train before finding the bag. Don't tell anyone about this offer.
Wait a minute.
Simple.
I thought this was hypothetical.
It's just one little thing. Shouldn't be too hard for next cop.
Wait, how did you know it?
Oh, that's me.
You're being serious, right?
You have until next stop to decide. What kind of person are you?
I'm not taking it.
It's black.
You got him.
Excuse me.
You're gonna want to move on, pal. The AC's out in here.
Actually, I was hoping you could help me. I'm looking for someone, a friend.
Okay.
They're going to Cold Spring, and I was wondering if you keep track of where everyone gets on and off the train.
Yeah, I take pictures, I hand out surveys, you know?
I didn't mean it like that.
Dude, it's tickets and zones, okay? They buy a ticket for a station, I punch the zone stuff, and put it on the seat. Boom.
Is that just day riders, or?
You said you're looking for your friend, right?
Yeah.
You don't know what they look like? You're asking me questions about passengers, about protocol.
I know it's stupid. We only talked online. She said she'd be here. Lives in Cold Spring.
You mean an online date? On a metro train? Yeah, I can't help you, pal. No one can. All right. You take it easy. Good luck.
Michael McCauley?
Yeah.
Found what you're looking for?
What?
No, are we doing this?
No. No, I can't.
Yeah, they thought you might say that.
Wait a minute. What is this?
It's a warning. In case you haven't figured it out yet, they're watching you. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. There's no service till 125th. Sometimes in the back, if you want. Don't quit out of my game.
You figure out who she was. The woman we saw earlier that was eyeballing you. Now, I figure that's where you went, looking for her. Hey, no judgment.
If I borrow the sports section?
No, yeah, sure.
Yeah. Thanks.
Yanks are playing the Sox.
Uh-huh.
5 wins to clinch. I'm feeling very confident. You know, my boy, he won't let me watch it on TV. He says it's bad for my blood pressure. As if the Yanks winning would give me a heart attack or something. Don't know why the kid is so worried. Kid spends more time watching me than he does at work. Yeah, and that is what I get for teaching a kid to do the right thing. Well, listen, I'm gonna stop by a bar and get a beer. Why don't you come with me?
I can't. I gotta make a call.
The model number you are trying to reach is unavailable.
The cell, please. It's an emergency. I'm a friend. Hey, Murph, it's Michael. Listen. I'm on this train just before Harlem. I don't know what the hell's up. This woman approached me out of nowhere. She wants me to find a passenger carrying some kind of bag. Murph, I think my... Just send someone to my house and call me back at this number, okay?
See you on the next go-round.
Stopping due to a red signal. We should be on our way in just a few minutes.
What the hell is this?
Look outside. Corner of MLK and Lexington. Quickly now. Southeast corner.
What do you want from me?
I want you to accept responsibility. We all suffer the burden of choice. No one forced you to take that money. Do you see him? We can't have your friends talking to the police.
I didn't tell them anything.
We both know that's not true.
Somebody get some help! Oh my God. What have you done?
You did this. You made your choice. Find Prin, find the bag. Or there will be further consequences.
You see what happened?
You listen to me. Listen.
No, you listen. I can get to anyone, anywhere. Your wife, Karen. Your son, Danny.
You touch my wife, my son. I swear to God.
I asked you to do one little thing. Don't make it more complicated than that. Don't make me hurt someone you love.
Wait. The day riders all have ticket stubs in the back of their seats. I can narrow down which passengers are going to Cold Spring.
Now we're getting somewhere.
What's in the bag? What do I do when I find it?
Check your right jacket pocket. Do you know what that is?
It's a GPS tracker.
Your time as a police officer wasn't for nothing. Plant the device on the bag, and it's all over. Dobbs Ferry Station, that's three stops, arrives 7 p.m. And Michael?
What?
Give the gentleman back his phone.
Sitting here. Excuse me, does this train go to Ten Wide River?
Yeah.
Ah, I saw that. Thank you. couldn't help but overhear earlier. You're a broker, right?
Can I help you with something?
I haven't seen you on the train before.
There's a reason for that.
You're riding for business, or... Well, my wife and I are getting ready to retire, and we're looking for a new broker.
I work for one of the largest investment banks in the world.
Great, that's exactly...
We don't represent people like you.
You're headed to Cold Spring. I figured maybe you were seeing a client out there.
What makes you think I'm going to Cold Spring?
I don't know.
What's your deal, man? Let me guess. Suit, the shoes, the watch. You probably worked sales the last 20 years. Now you want to turn your nest egg into a 3-week timeshare in Maui. Yeah. No, they got me on a train to nowhere. Seriously, I never should have left Goldman Sachs.
Hey, Goldman Sachs, on behalf of the American middle class, fuck you.
Sorry, Mark, go ahead. There's nothing.
Long day, huh, Sherry?
Yeah. But you've been busy, huh? Up and down the aisle the whole time?
Karen's been on me to get more exercises, either the train or Pilates.
How is the family?
Good, good. Danny's headed off to Syracuse.
Wow, you must be really proud.
Yeah, he's trying to decide between the dorms or an apartment. The dorms, an apartment. Excuse me. Hello. You go to Columbia, right? T-shirt. Are you a photography student? I noticed your camera case.
I don't know. I'm sorry.
Millennials, huh?
Excuse me. If you just wait.
Now arriving.
I only want to talk.
Are you crazy?
What is this?
Nothing. Can you just stop it?
Fake IDs?
They're not mine, I swear to God. They're my boyfriend's, and he asked me if I could carry it because he would get caught. Are you a cop?
No, I'm not a cop. But listen, if he really cared about you, he wouldn't ask you to do something like this.
You okay?
Next stop, Tarantino.
Sitting together, three of them.
Right.
And 125th is split up, each to a different car. I don't know, it felt weird.
I'm only authorized to search a bag if it's been left behind.
You know I ride this line every day. Like I said, maybe it's nothing. See something, say something, right?
You point them out to me.
Yeah. A woman there. A nurse. Man in the second car, African-American with a guitar. Another in the last car, all going to Cold Spring.
Security checks, and I just need to take a look at your bag.
Why?
I just need to take a look at your bag.
Hey! All right. What you were doing?
It's a random security check. Get back to your books. Get back to your books. I just need to take a look at your bag now.
I just need to take a look at your bag. Seriously, why me? Why my back?
It's just disturbing everybody. It's just...
just told you, ma'am. It's a random security check. Now, do me a favor, will you? Just open your bag. I'm sorry.
No.
Just open your bag, and I'll be on my way.
I got a visual, but I can't get to anything yet. I just need a bit more time.
Who are you? Come down.
Why are you following me?
Are you the reason they're searching passengers?
Crane?
What did you say?
Get up!
He's freaking me out.
Some guy says he's a cop. Now, you don't look so good. Everything all right?
Give me a minute, will you? Murph.
Mike.
Send someone to the house.
Tarrytown local, they're on the way. What the hell's going on? Mike.
This woman sits across from me, calls herself Joanna. She offers me $100,000 to find someone on the train. You want his bag.
$100,000? What kind of bag?
I don't know, but it sounds crazy. They threatened Karen and Danny. They killed a man or pushed him into the street.
Jesus Christ. Okay. You still on the train?
Yeah.
I don't do anything. I'm gonna call a friend at the Transportation Authority.
I found him, Murph. I didn't have a choice.
What did you do?
They gave me a GPS tracker. The kid's late 20s, black duffel bag. A snakehead tattoo on his neck. Goes by the name of Prin.
Prin? Did you take the money, Mike? You want my help as a detective or as a friend? Because it's two very different things.
What are you not telling, Murph?
2 nights ago, a buddy of mine in the 9th called a suicide downtown, a staffer in the city planning office. It's all over the news. The thing is, this kid was in deep with the wrong kind of people. There's a witness. Saw two guys dropping 35 stories out a window. Witness goes by Prin.
And I identified him. Someone in this train's gonna kill him. Jesus. I had an altercation with the guy. I got a bag full of cash. Just lost my job. She's trying to set me up.
All right, this is what you're gonna do. Next stop, get up.
Murph? Hello? Murph?
You done? Come on, man. What the hell is wrong with you?
Sorry, Tony. Thanks.
Great. Thanks for using my battery up, asshole.
Why are we meeting a witness outside the city? Feels wrong.
20 minutes. All right. I'm checking in with Agent Foster.
As long as the witness gets off that train.
You did, Michael. Another dead passenger.
This man was a federal agent.
Yes, but he's not Prynne. You marked the wrong man.
You killed him.
Whose fault is that?
I didn't agree to this.
You tell yourself that. I know you think you're a good man, but some part of you was willing. Some part of you capable of condemning a stranger to an unknown fate.
I'm done playing games. I want to talk to my wife.
Stay with me, Michael. You still have a job to do.
I will not do a goddamn thing until I know my wife and my son are okay.
They're just leaving the house now.
Mom, come on. We're gonna be late.
Danny, have you seen my ring? I swear I left it on the bathroom counter.
Have you asked Dad?
He's not picking up his phone as usual.
Mom, who is that?
Danny, get in the car. Lock the door. Can I help you?
Are you Karen McCauley?
Yes.
I'm here because of your husband.
I'm sorry. Who are you? No. You have a beautiful family, Michael.
There are police on their way right now. If your men try anything...
Yes, they were, Michael. They were. Until you called too much attention to yourself.
What?
Look outside. Someone reported a dangerous individual on the train. Now, you're standing over a corpse. Do the math.
What do you want me to do?
Don't leave the train and don't get caught.
Time, I'm telling you, he's a regular. I don't think he's dangerous.
The guy claims he's looking for someone on board. He makes up some bullshit story about suspicious bags, and then he gets into a fight.